Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. It's your girl Juice, and we are back at it again with another hair tutorial. Thank you so much for tuning in. If you're new, please do me a favor and click the subscribe button. If you are old, thank you, and welcome back to another episode. But we're just gonna hop right into this video. As you guys can see, I've already started making the wig and I'm just drawing my guidelines. So we're just gonna pop in right here and we're gonna walk through this video. In this video, I'm going to be making a wig using 3 bundles of tight curls and a matching closure from my brand, of course, Juice Styles. Make sure to check that out. But right now, I'm just drawing my guidelines, which are about an inch apart. As you guys can see, it's about like an inch and a half, but they're pretty close because it's like 3 bundles, and you want to make sure that, you know, as you get to the top, everything is getting closer and closer where you don't have any gaps, okay? So that's just what I did there. As you can see, the top was closer. This unit is going to be a machine made unit, so here I am just prepping my machine, and then I'm gonna follow up by prepping my bundles to get them ready for, you know, the machine making process. I don't think that I'm going to be explaining this in detail because I do have another video on my page that explains how I create my wigs on a machine. So if any detail is missing, just try to check that video out, because you'll probably find your answer within that video as well. Of course, I had to hit the slow-mo because I want you guys to see how bouncy these bundles are. So I'm just gonna say, you know, check me out, baby, Juice Styles. Check out the links, check out the bio, you know, check everything out. Make sure you shop as well. Just, you know, support black businesses. So after I cut my weft into 2 sections, I went ahead and I doubled my weft. So that's what I'm gonna be doing right here. And doubling the weft, as you guys may or may not know, is basically having 2 wefts side by side sewn together, and it makes it easier for you to add on more bundles to your wig without it being all bulky. It just makes it, you know, slimmer and, you know, good to go. Nobody wanna be walking around with bulks and bridges in their head, like, no. After doubling the wefts to my first bundle, I went ahead and followed the same steps for the second bundle. I do this because usually when I'm working with 3 bundles, I like to pre-prepare or preset my bundles, and I would, you know, double the wefts to the first 2 bundles that get laid first, and then I would single weft with that last bundle, the one that goes around the crown. After doubling my wefts, I go ahead and match up that doubled weft against my guidelines, and then I stitch and backstitch to seal that stitching, and then I go ahead and just sew the doubled wefts onto my cap. While sewing on the sewing machine, I definitely do cut my weft. Like, it gives you the flattest, most amazing finish. Like, you're not gonna mess up your wig by cutting your weft. Like, that's just not gonna happen if you have good hair. So being that you're cutting it, you should be able to brush it out and shake it off and go about your business after you complete your wig. So yeah, there's no, you're not doing anything wrong. So go ahead and cut your weft. While I was stitching, I did run out of bobbin thread, so I went ahead and filled up my bobbin, and that's what you guys are watching me do here. It's a pretty simple process. When I first started on the sewing machine, girl, I did not know what the hell I was doing. Like, and mind you, this was not the first time that I encountered the sewing machine, because I definitely did, you know, sew back in high school, but it was through a program. So when I got back to doing it with the wigs, it was a whole different ball game. So it was just like, baby girl, what's going on? So when I got to my last bundle, I went ahead and doubled half of that bundle. This was only because of the simple fact that I found myself having way more hair left than I anticipated. So I wanted to pack as much as I could onto that wig without, you know, making it bulky. So I went ahead and I doubled half of it, and then I single weft the rest onto the cap. Can't even speak English. Oh my God. So as you guys can see, once you get to the top of the wig, like once you get to the crown area on the sewing machine, it's usually more technical. It's kind of, you know, it's a bit harder because it's just so tight, you know, there's not much space there. So you just have to eye it. You really have to watch out so that you don't make any mistakes, and you just patience is key. So as much patience as you put into this, like, you'll get it. It's frustrating, but you'll definitely get it. Now that I completely, you know, sewed all my wefts onto that cap, I'm just gonna go ahead and do the regular, you know, the regular cut out the bottom of that, you know, cap, so that your lace can, you know, be, you know, be its lace, be free, you know, like, you already know the deal. As you guys can see, the cutout has been successful. You know, it's an operation. You know, you don't want to move too fast, you could mess up that lace. So if you're a first timer, please be careful. But if you know what you're doing, then you know what you're doing. So yeah, after that I just take it apart and I'm just gonna get it ready to be bleached, because you know, we're bleaching those knots. Nobody want to be walking around with ants on their head now. Can't be doing that. I decided to include the clip of me, you know, bleaching the knots. And to bleach my knots, I usually use my BW2 and my 30 volume developer. I know you guys can't, oh, there you go, you see it. But yeah, so then I just mix that, and the consistency that I'm going for is kind of like a pancake batter, a thick pancake batter, so it doesn't seep through the lace, because if you make it too liquidy, you're hair is going to be turning blonde, like the strands itself, not just the knots, and you do not want that, because then that's how you look like you have a whole bunch of bald spots going on in your hair. We don't want that. Like, we don't, baby girl, we don't. We don't need it. We don't. I hope you guys have enjoyed this video. Thank you so much for tuning in. I really do appreciate you guys. If you are new and you have made it this far, girl, join the team. Hey, baby girl, what's up? What happened? Subscribe. And if you are an old viewer, thank you so much for returning. I really do appreciate you guys. If you guys have any topics, suggestions, comment them below. And don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. You guys already know what's up and what it is.
Yikes. Work hard, just a different way. Get your life. You bitches ain't living right. Bag talk, but ain't got no mouth for money. Bag talk. It's quiet, ain't no bag.